He was not just my father, he was my best friend. My woman keep me
warm. When did you realise, Roger, that your father was famous?
When I was on tour, travelling around, and my schools had to coordinate and such, so it was, I knew I was living a different life than a lot of the other children. It was normal to me. And I watched basically all my father's performances from the wings.
Did he ask you? Was he like, you know, did he go well, son?
You know, the thing is, the truth is, he was always infallible, really.
An album like Saturday Night Fever is just, everybody has it, everybody knows it. But did they know at that time that they were making these durable songs?
They'd been dabbling just as a coincidence with that sort of music, with funk and soul, and I guess it just all came together, really. When they first heard it, he said, oh, maybe we should call it Saturday Night, but they knew so many other films had been called Saturday Night. So, eventually, I think it was between Saturday Night and Night Fever they were going to call it, so they just melded the two.
When you found out that was your first number one record, what went through your mind?
Wow, this is our first number one record.
Yeah, I did meet your father.
Very dry wit.
He was very, you didn't know at first if he was joking, and then, oh, I think he is joking, yeah. When you mentioned your uncles and obviously your father, they spent their formative years in Australia.
Yes.
Can you talk about that?
He loved Australia. They started on the racetracks, going to the racetracks and performing for pennies and whatever people would give. And then they were taken on by local radio guy, and that's how it all started. And of course, they nurtured their voices in a lot of the. My father always used to say, we've sung in some of the best toilets in Australia.
But it's great acoustics, as you say. We recently had some movies, very successful movies, one on Freddie Mercury, of course, one with Sir Elton John. Mm-hmm. Do you think there could ever be a movie about the Bee Gees?
There's quite a few things going on, so but I'm not, I can't go into any detail, but we'll see what happens. I mean, as you say, it's one of those stories that just writes itself, isn't it? I mean, and it's just screaming to be seen, to be.
Who would you like to your dad to be played by them?
They don't have to look exactly like the person. I think it's the mannerisms, and if they can do the voice,
you could do it.
Thank you.
How would you think your father would think today about the wonderful legacy that he's left?
I think he was very proud of what he did, accomplished.
Yeah.
And I think for him it never ended. So he would always be coming up with new ideas and always back in the studio, up until the time he couldn't, up until the time he was in hospital full time. I mean, I would think about a week before that we were in the studio, so.
Well, music keeps you going, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah, that kept him going for a long time as well. Yeah, you're right. That's just history, really. You may not think I care for you when you know down inside that I really do. And it's me you need to show. How deep is your love?
Talk about a catalogue of great songs, goodness me. For details on RJ Gibb's show, head to rjgibb.co.uk.